Was COVID a faith builder or a stumbling block? We're getting back to normal. We're you know, things are seemingly calming down. So yeah, what do we think of this?
I feel like it didn't change for my family. It didn't change, you know, our routine so much. Our church stayed open.
Yeah.
So nothing really changed that way. However, I do feel like it opened our eyes to what was really going on in the world, what's really going on in the spirit.
Yeah.
How the demonic is really giving its push.
Right.
So I think it pushed us to be bolder, dive deeper into the Lord, be stronger, stand on his promises more and his word more. So I think it was a good push for a lot of people.
Yeah.
It was a big revealing time. I feel like God really revealed a lot during that time. Who is going to stand strong for him and who's going to bow. Mm-hmm. And you really watched how a lot of people bowed.
For me and for Paul, we just kept doing what we were doing. We were wake up, read our Bible. The only time in my life that I've ever found it to be difficult is when I'm not consistently in my word.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So for me, it didn't matter. I never once feared COVID. Never. And I don't say that to say, pat me on the back. I mean, to say that sincerely. I didn't fear. I told my kids, we're not going to fear. This is silly. Even if it was what they were saying, which it wasn't. Oh, it's wiping everybody out. Then take, however I'm going to, I signed my life away to Jesus. However I'm going to go, I'm going to go. I refuse to fear. I did push. I would try to go in, you know, no mask and try to just kind of, because I just, it wasn't for me.
Yeah.
So for most of the time, it didn't really, it didn't change anything as long as I was waking up in my word, staying with Jesus. Now, we were very blessed because we were at a fantastic church that never closed. Mm-hmm. So my kids still got that every week and being with their friends. But it really comes down to your personal relationship in any situation, whether it's COVID, whether whatever you're walking through. Are you rooted in the word of God? And what does it, do you know what it says about you as a child of him? Mm-hmm. There was no need to fear. There was no need to panic. It was what it was.
I think, Brittany, just to go off of what you're saying, and I think, Jean, you mentioned it earlier, is just not only reading your word, but knowing who you are. Mm-hmm. I think a lack of identity and a lack of foundation is what has unfortunately led a lot of people into fear, or led a lot of people to just be sheep and go along with what everyone else is saying is and doing, when you have the power and the authority in the name of Jesus and in who you are, Jesus, to stand up and say, no, that's not for me. That's not who I am. That's not what I believe. And you can stand up and rise up in who you are as a person and hold on to your identity rather than letting it fall apart. Because if you are just going along with whatever everybody else has been saying over the past year and a half, it may possibly be because you lack an identity and a foundation in Jesus. So I think as we come out of all this and you assess who you are, and I think really taking a look at where your identity is being established. Is it being established in the world and in the culture and in COVID and what we should be doing and how we can protect ourselves and how we should be protecting other people? And should I wear a mask? Should I get a vaccine? No. You stop and you say, okay, where is my foundation? Because if my foundation is in the name of Jesus, that stuff will not matter. Mm-hmm. And you will know who you are and you will be able to stand firm in what you believe in.
One, God has not given us a spirit of fear. That's there is nothing to fear.
Right.
And two, let's take our encouragement and where God has planted us in this time and encourage others. So let's use our overflow and give back to others. Let's spill out the encouragement and the faith that it has brought us, you know? Okay, so we, like Lauren was saying, we didn't fear, you know, because we're grounded in the word of God. And so if that's you, then we need to be spilling our faith to others, not being quiet, not being like, oh, those crazy people over there. No, because those people are really hurting. So how can we spill over what we have for to others?
And also use it as a learning curve. If you are one of those people that was just gripped by fear, look at it and say, hey, I'm not going to do that next time this happens.
Right.
I'm going to say no, and I'm going to choose to walk by faith and not by sight, and I'm going to speak what I want to see, and I'm going to stay rooted in my word and use it as a learning curve to just continue to deepen. That's how we grow in faith.
Yeah.
You literally, my faith has grown because of the things I've been through. Some of the ways I've reacted to some trauma or disappointment in my life has not been great. Well, that didn't grow my faith.
Right. Mm-hmm.
But I took that and said, hey, next time that happens, I'm not going to do that.
Absolutely.
So it is okay. Get right back on that horse and you just keep on going. That's how we grow.
And you use your discernment. You use the Holy Spirit. You tap into that spirit, you know, to that spirit man inside of you and you use your discernment. Mm-hmm. You know, is this okay? Let me use my discernment and my brain, my God-given brain, and say, is this something that I should worry about and protect my children from? Or is this something that maybe we should just pray about?